Why did I buy this 2016 Yamaha R1 Double R? I wanted to make this blog because since I started riding, I always wondered, when I see people with their bikes, I always wondered what made them choose that specific bike. I've always wondered that. Because remember, bikes aren't like cars. Sometimes some people buy a car, you know, because it's economic. Or they'll buy a car because it's a popular car that everyone has. Even though they do that with bikes too, but with a bike, a lot of people buy a bike that it's mostly suited to them or they really liked it. So I've always wondered when I see people with their bikes, I'm like, I wonder why he chose that bike, you know? Well, the biker there today, he knows what's up. He knows this weather's good. Today I wanted to talk about why I chose this bike, the 2016 Yamaha R1. I think in the area where I'm at, I could probably show you why I chose it. I don't want to get a little too crazy, but I'm going to talk about why I chose it in a few. But you see here why I chose it. Calm down a little bit. This is why I chose this bike. This bike is lethal, man. It's lethal. And I'm not just upselling it because it's my bike. Before I bought this bike, I did a lot of research.
Next time, maybe do a little research.
I had the 2010 R1, the model before this one, and that one didn't have traction control, none of that shit. It was just a regular bike. But I always say, you know, my ZX9, which was my first bike, yeah, I learned a lot on that one too. But I learned a lot about the basics of riding on that one. But on the R1, when I got the R1, that's when I really, really learned how to ride. That's when I really, really, you know, I was able to go a little bit faster, you know, be confident a little bit more on the turns, you know. Of course, I was a little bit older and I had been riding for a little bit longer. But that 2010 R1, it really complements you riding, you know. For it to look, it looks like a bulky bike. And it is, like 455 pounds or something like that. But for the way it looks, it's very nimble. Don't let it fool you. And for the power that it has, it's very nimble. So I started looking at a lot of bikes before I bought this one, like the Ducati. The ZX10R was a big one of mine. I like the Kawasaki's because with the ZX9R that I had, it never gave me problems. So that's one big thing for me, is if a bike doesn't give you problems, I'm on board, man. I'm on board. So yeah, I was looking at a lot of bikes. I was looking at the Ducati 1299. That was a big favorite of mine. Of course, this new R1 was a big favorite of mine. The ZX10, as I said before, because of the reliability. Tons of power on that bike. But I ultimately ended up choosing the R1. One, because of my past experience with it. And two, throughout that 1 year span, because I took one year literally to save up so I could have a really good down payment for it. And throughout that 1 year span, I think I must have watched over 200 videos on this bike. And some other bikes too. But on this bike, and I was watching for the 2015, and well, I like to say 99% of the videos, nobody ever really said anything wrong with this bike. You know, like nobody really had a complaint with it. And it wasn't only about having complaint with it, it was they praised it a lot. Like, there was this guy from MCN who's like, I guess, I don't know if he was a world superbike champion or something like that. And he test rode the bike, and he, you know, he ripped it. He's a world superbike champion. And he got to the point where he was eating up the tires, and he was talking about it. You know, guys like that, they can actually tell the difference between, you know, when a bike and the tires really wear down, when you're really leaned over, they can really tell the difference on, you know, what bike is good or not.
Mid-corner, it's planted. The thing is sucked down on the ground and it is hooked up. And the new stuff, it's so seamless and so well designed that it allows you just to focus on riding and the track ahead of you. I don't think any other manufacturer is gonna be able to compete with Yamaha in the electronics package.
Us as regular people or aspiring track riders, we're not that good yet, you know? And what he was saying was that, you know, they showed the tire after his, like, I don't know if it was like his last track session. His tire was chewed up. There was even pieces coming out of it. And he was talking about it. He said his lap times were a little bit slower, but the bike was still handling like a dream. And for those little bits of negatives, like the tire being worn down and everything, the bike still, it made up for it with the, you know, the traction control and the slide control. And he said he can actually feel the thing, you know, sliding around, but killing the power enough so he didn't get into trouble. So ultimately, I ended up, you know, with the electronics package and everything on this bike, I ended up picking this bike. And then, you know, I heard some things like with the Ducati, you know, like they were saying that, you know, it had a lot of power and everything, it's a beautiful bike, but they were saying, I don't know if it's because of the frame or what it was, that the bike was a little bit harder to handle the power. It has a lot of, a heck of a lot of power too on that 1299. Now they got the V4 and they outdid themselves with that one. But, you know, I wanted to get something that had a lot of power, but I can become better at the track, because I got into track riding maybe about 2 years ago and I really love it. I'm really into it now. I really want to get faster. And this bike, they were saying, you know, this bike is an easy bike to, you know, it's a 1000, but it's an easy bike, like, to really get faster on. And, you know, a 600 would be ideal, but I love the R1, you know, it's whatever you like. I chose this bike, you know, the bike is light, it's really light. I think it's like 438 pounds wet. But if you take the cat off, and let's say you put an aftermarket exhaust like I did, I have a SC Project, which is full titanium and it's a little pipe. I swear that thing weighs like about five pounds. You take off the cat, that's 12 pounds. So now, you know, you're sitting at like 420 something with a 1000. You know, that's a long way from the old days when they were 450 and 460. And then we have more power now out of the 1000s. So that power trade-off with the lightness of the bike is just a lethal combination. love that. I love in first and second gear on this bike, first, second, and sometimes third if you're really ripping it. First and third if you're really ripping it, the bike will go up. First, second, and third. Mostly first and second. Some might even say I'm in a relationship with this bike. Think about it all the time. It's crazy. This is love. This is true love. Yeah. In closing, I bought this bike because I thought it would be the best fit for me. After doing a lot of research, spending 1 year of trying to save up after I sold my other bike to put a good down payment, I felt this was the best fit for me. I felt that it was the best bike that would help me advance as a rider, and it would be comfortable for me, you know, to where every day I would get on it and be happy and look at it and say that, you know, that's my bike, you know? That's why I chose this Yamaha R1. But I think I might have to boogie home. It's looking like it's gonna start raining soon. I guess we are gonna get the rain after all. Thank you guys for watching the video. Thanks to the people that watch the videos and leave comments and stuff like that. We love you guys. We support you guys too. You guys are great. Keep watching us and we're gonna keep trying to make great content for you guys. That's one thing we do. We really try hard to make our videos as good as possible and as comical as possible. Thank you guys.